It has been over 8 years since the attacks on September 11th. In those 8 years, reconstruction at Ground Zero has waned. Few plants have truly flourished, many others have faltered, and most have inevitably failed. Whether it has been the dissatisfaction of many over designs for the Freedom Tower, security concerns posed by the New York Police Department, or the ongoing struggle to secure funding, progress at the site has been, for the better part of these 8 years, minute. With the entire world watching, New York has crept along in its redevelopment of a land once occupied by the World Trade Center. And in doing so, the city has influenced a great disconnect among New Yorkers over the very notion of reconstruction. There are those who strongly believe that development should have already taken place because it needed to, namely, for the good of the city and its people.
Conversely, there are those who argue that rushing development, both from a financial as well as a practical standpoint, would have invariably caused heightened tensions among the people of New York, especially those who were personally affected by the tragedies of 9/11. As the 10-year anniversary of the World Trade Center attack steadfastly approaches, the time is now for reconstruction. But whether the current plans in place are best for businesses and residents of the area, as well as the victims' families, remains up for debate. With the Port Authority openly stating that a 9/11 memorial will not be opened by the decennial of the attacks, matched with a 2012 estimated completion date of the Freedom Tower, it appears as if the city, under Mayor Bloomberg's watch, has dropped the ball on reconstruction entirely. For a better understanding of the current plans, let's first take a look at how reconstruction plans have gotten to where they are now.
Three individuals were asked about their top two preferences out of six options regarding reconstruction: rebuild the towers as they were, construct a memorial, develop residential space, build a sports stadium, or go forward with the current plan, or choose something else. Our New York City politics class, Fordham University students, New Yorkers, and tourists all had a chance to participate. Though no one plan was chosen a majority of the time, 34% of the total votes were in favor of the current plan. The option to solely build a memorial was the one chosen most often after that, with 22% of votes. Members of our class, as well as other Fordham University students polled, favored primarily the current plan and then the memorial. Of the 34 New Yorkers polled, 25% of their votes were for the current plan, but only 15%, fourth best, favored a memorial. Tied for a second with 22% of votes were developing residential space and other, which included building a large park, cultural center, or public housing complex. Where are you from?
New Jersey.
New Jersey. And do you know anything about the reconstruction plans for the World Trade Center?
From Freedom Tower, something is being constructed, right? That's what I know.
Okay, and you?
I have some idea.
Okay, thank you.
Where are you from?
From Ireland.
Okay, and what do you know about the reconstruction plans for the World Trade Center?
I know they're building a single skyscraper in the original site, and I think there was a bit of a competition for it and some controversy as to the design and so on, but I think they're going ahead with whatever they've decided with now.
And if you had a choice as a foreigner, would you want them to continue with what they're doing, or would you prefer to see a memorial in this space?
I think a building is probably fine.
Okay, thank you very much. Are you a resident of New York?
I am.
And how long have you lived here?
I just moved here about 4 months ago from Long Island. I live about 5 blocks south, right on Battery Park.
And do you know anything about the reconstruction of the World Trade Center site?
I do, yeah. In fact, this building right behind us here is Tower 1. They're just above what they call the platform, which is the base level that's going to have all the stores. The latest agreement was reached about a month ago, which is Silverstein can build Tower 3 as long as he gets, I believe it's $400 million worth of guaranteed tenants, meaning people signing a lease saying they're willing to lease the space before the building's even built.
And do you believe that he's going to be able to get that sort of money?
I don't think so, because from what I see, there's about, I would say 30% is probably a good number of what's open space right now as far as offices go.
Can I ask you why you know so much about what's going on with the construction?
Because I was living in New York when the towers fell, and I came to see the site about 7 or 8 days after the towers fell. I feel like I'm pretty close to what actually happened.
The first World Trade Center was constructed by the force that is David Rockefeller and the will of the Port Authority, with the hunger to prove that New York was bigger and better than ever. Despite the top-down process, the project took decades to complete. Whether loved or hated, the future World Trade Center will undoubtedly become as big a part of New York City as the Twin Towers once were. The process of deciding what to build and how on such a large and significant site is inevitably a complicated process. With the competing interests of the city, the state, victims' families, government offices and organizations, businesses, politicians, leaseholders, artists, nearby residents, and tourists all coming into play, it's no surprise that the people are frustrated. What is important to remember is that regardless of the aesthetic or function of the future site, what will truly make the World Trade Center a product of the 21st century is the input and representation that all of these people can and should have in the rebuilding process. At the end of the day, however, construction has finally begun at Ground Zero, and an exhausted but happy public is delighted to see that something is getting done. Maybe there will be too much office space or too little emphasis on the memorial, but at least in the opinion of the people at large, we will have something that we can consider our own.